Steve, what sort of competition will the Champions Trophy next year be?
Well, I think we're hoping for an incredibly high-intensity, high-impact swan song, really, if you will, for the event. Yes, we know it's the last Champions Trophy that's going to be hosted. It possibly is sometimes. It's had a bit of a bad rap, but I really view it as a bit of a hidden gem, because I think when you look at the format and you have a look at the structure and you see some of the matches in the tournament in that June month, it's going to be an unbelievable series. And I think when they see who they're playing, you've got three group games and you're fighting for two positions out of four, the intensity of the head-to-heads is going to be what's going to drive a lot of this, the intensity of that cricket. So, from a hope and aspirational point of view, absolutely, we want to see full stadiums. We want to see fantastic cricket on the field. It's a short, sharp competition. It's over 18 days. Top eight teams in the world. We've seen some unbelievable cricket over the last 6 months. Any one of those sides can win it. We've seen incredibly good young fast bowlers coming through, unbelievable spinners, batters who are just clearing the boundary at will nowadays. So I think if you stack it all up, it really is something that can turn out to be special and real focus in the heart of the summer for us.
I suppose you're hoping for something akin to 2009 in the World T20, which was so fantastic on these shores.
Absolutely, it mirrors that. You've got a spring series before, we had a global event in June as well, and then you had an Ashes straight afterwards, and this is mirroring it exactly the same. And I think, the focus and what we've seen around Ashes series is just unbelievable, and I think the support that it engenders is just fantastic. But this event itself is going to cap off a fantastic summer of cricket for us.
England always enjoy good support, but teams visiting always enjoy good support as well. I remember 2009, the Pakistan games, the India games, they were sold out with fans supporting those sides too, and we can expect the same.
Oh, absolutely. I think some of those heads up, as we said, the matches against these sides, we've got, as a precursor, you've got Australia playing England up at Edgbaston, you've got an India-Pakistan match, you've got West Indies against Pakistan at the Oval with a massive Caribbean population around the Oval, India-South Africa is the opening game down in Cardiff. So, I think if you talk about the multicultural nature of the support we've had, really you're tapping into eight different population groups, and there's no better place in the world to tap into that. You think of the geographical spread of the three venues, one in the Midlands, one in London, one down in Wales in Cardiff. I really think we've really got a top tournament coming. We've structured the ticket prices so that they're absolutely accessible, under 16 ticket at £5, an under 21 ticket, because the jump from an under 16 to an adult ticket is quite a jump, and that's between £10 and £20. A family of four can go and watch a group game for £50, and that's incredible value for money. And you think that, from our point of view, is the thread that runs through the entire tournament. We want to attract new people to the ground. We want to attract the young, the families, family stand, non-alcohol, one of the fastest selling stands in 2009. We've replicated that again for 2013, and we hope we're going to get the same support from the fans.
Champions Trophy has a place in your heart. You played in the 1998 version, which was the first one, South Africa won, and you played.
Yeah, absolutely. It's quite a peculiar feeling, actually. Looking through the last night, actually, just picking through a few of the photos I've got in my online library, basically, and having a look at some of those pictures of holding the trophy with a couple of those South African fans and huddled around the trophy in front of the board as champions of 1998 in Dhaka in Bangladesh, first global tournament you'd ever won, beat West Indies there. Unbelievable feeling, to be able to win a global event. And now being in charge of running the final one. Quite a peculiar feeling, but it's a fantastic opportunity, and I certainly hope we're going to give it the credibility it deserves at the end of it.